So before we get into the code, I want to share a high-level overview of how distributed data parallel, or DDP, works in PyTorch. In non-distributed training, you have a model on one GPU, and the training process here should be pretty familiar. Your model receives an input batch from the data loader. It does the forward pass to calculate the loss, does the backward pass to calculate parameter gradients, which then the optimizer uses to update the model. And if you'd like a quick refresher on model training in PyTorch, I recommend the PyTorch Basics tutorial. So when we distribute this training job to, let's say, 4 GPUs, DDP launches one process per GPU, where each process has its own local copy of the model. And as the word suggests, all replicas of the model and optimizers are identical to each other. Not only are the initial model parameters the same, even the optimizers use the same random seed. DDP internally maintains this synchronization throughout the training process. Now at this stage, each GPU process has the same model. What we are going to change up is the data. So like before, we get our input batch from the data loader, but this time we also use distributed sampler. The sampler ensures that each process receives different inputs, and this is the data parallel in DDP. We are now concurrently processing effectively 4 times the data compared to single GPU training. At each process, the model receives a different input, locally runs the forward and backward pass, and because the inputs were different, the gradients that are accumulated now are also different. Running an optimizer step at this point would result in different parameters across our devices, and we'd end up with 4 distinct models instead of a single distributed model. So instead, at this stage, DDP initiates a synchronization step. Gradients from all the replicas are aggregated using the bucketed ring all-reduce algorithm. And the cool thing about this algorithm is that it overlaps gradient computation with communication. The synchronization step doesn't wait for all the gradients to be computed. Instead, it starts communication along the ring while the backward pass is still running. This ensures that your GPU is always working and not idle. Now, each model replica has the same gradients. Running the optimizer step now will update all the replicas' parameters to the same values. When we started, the replicas across all processes were identical, and now at the end, they continue to remain in sync. This concludes one DDP training step, and the identical replicas are ready for the next iteration.